All right, guys. First of all, I'd like to say thanks for all the nice comments and my recent subscribers on my videos. I'm glad you guys are enjoying them. And this is a little tips video on how to train in the training range. This is what I do when I come in here anyway. And sorry, just close the door in this room here. It's what I do in here anyway to practice training. So this is sort of what I do. So basically what I do is I like to grab like common guns that can be picked up or not, whatever, any kind of guns. You should really train with all the guns, actually. But I don't like to put attachments on it that makes it easier as far as recoil is concerned. I like to be able to practice controlling my recoil. So I don't pick up any of these attachments like stocks or grips or anything. I only pick up the quick draw extended mags, which will make me reload faster and have more ammo. That's the only thing that I pick up when I train. And I pick up, a variety of scopes. So in this case, I have a two-time scope and a holographic and an eight-time scope. At least I thought I had a. Is that a holographic on there? No. Okay. Well, I'm gonna pick up a holographic also. Thought I had that already. I guess not. Pick that up also. So yeah, basically the first thing that I like to do when I come into the training range is, well, one of the things you can do is practice strafing and shooting. That's run back and forth like this. Try to keep your crosshair on the target that you're shooting at, and hit it just like that. Try to stay strafing while you're doing this. You can zoom in, or scope in rather, ADS. While you're strafing, practice that. Try to stay moving while you're doing it. You can practice in single shot if you really want to practice your accuracy. Try to hit the targets in one shot if possible. And this guy is acting like a fucking retard, but that's okay because that just adds an extra challenge for me to, still hit my target. So practice leaning and shooting, practice hip fire, practice ADSing, try to hit your targets as quickly as possible, rapid target acquisition. That manual dexterity to be able to do like a 360, hit your target quickly. You should be able to move, have, total freedom of movement. And if you would like that, please check out my HUD tutorial on claw, and you can set up your claw setup like me. If you want total freedom of movement. However, if you are a thumbs player and that works for you, that's cool too. I got nothing against that. So it's whatever works for you as long as you have total freedom of movement and are able to do whatever you need to do, whatever you shouldn't have any restriction of movement at all, is what I'm saying. So that guy thought he was gonna hit me, but no. You should be able to do everything through muscle memory. Whether it's, jumping or crouching, you shouldn't even have to think about it. Have your setup so you can do those things without thinking about it. So anyway, yeah, you're practicing. This guy's gonna. I hate these guys that come into the training range and they don't actually train. They just come in here and fuck around. It's like, okay, you can waste your own time, but don't waste my time. So basically, that's what I like to do with that. Like to strafe and shoot. Just practice strafing like that. You can practice on these targets too. Hitting each target as best you can, as quickly as possible. Rapid target acquisition. This guy's just adding to the difficulty, so that's fine. That's all I look at it as. Try to hit headshots as much as you can. See, this guy's this is the type of thing that we have to deal with Tencent. I don't know why Tencent has vehicles in the same place and grenades too. That's another thing that people piss me off with. In the same place that people are trying to train, it makes no fucking sense. So hopefully they can fix that someday. I doubt they ever will. So that's that part. And now I will show you another part, which is over here, where the grenades are. All right, so in this part, you can see we have targets that are moving. And what you want to do is, this guy is still pissing me off. What you want to do is try to hit the target when it's inside the window. It's harder to do, well, it's just generally hard to do. Especially when you're strafing. Try to do that. So what you want to do is try and hit the targets while they're in the window, at the time that they're in the window. So like that, not like that. It's just timing, right? So you'd be able to see somebody when they're in the window and shoot them at that time. Try to ADS right at that moment that they're in there, like that, just like that. All right, so I'm out of ammo on that one. That's fine. You can lose, like, I'll just use my handgun to demonstrate this further. So you want to get it like right when he's inside the window. Pretty hard to do. Okay, and so that's that. I'll show you another thing over here. Another thing you can do actually is while you're running, you can still shoot while you're running. Just like that, you're just leaving the sprint button on. So you're running and shooting at the same time. You're just kind of at a light jog. It's harder to do because you're not stopping running. Try to get a headshot if you can. Practice heat firing like that. You can lean and continue running like that also. And so over here, I like to take a shot, spin 180, take a shot. This guy again, spin 180, take a shot. Spin 180, take a shot. That's basically what you do because you have these two targets. So you practice doing 180s and shooting at the same time. Just like that, headshot. 180, take a shot. Try to do it as quickly, as smoothly, as accurately as you possibly can. Just like that, headshot. So I missed that one, but at least I hit the actual target. Spin both ways, 180. Oops, missed. Okay, so we're gonna stay on this one. There we go. Do 180s each time. Oops, missed again. You will miss shots. I mean, that's the whole point of it. Get better. Throw in leaning as well. There we go. So yeah, that's what I do over here in this part. Just 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, and you get to get used to 180ing like that. And, try to be as accurate as possible. Same thing, 180, 180. This will probably help you. Can do with hip fire. This will probably help you more than anything else. Is this 180 training, just like that. So yeah, that's, I guess that's one, two, three. Three of the things that I do in training. In a typical training session. That's what I do. I might practice like crouching too, you know, in my 360. The idea is of these 360s is yeah, it's a trick shot, and you're not really gonna do this in a real game. But what it does is it helps you with your rapid target acquisition, because it kind of disorients you and you have to find your target really quickly after. So that's the point of doing those. It helps you, you know, learn to recover and get off your shot as quickly as possible. Because usually, even when you're strafing, you can kind of keep your crosshair on the target. You can kind of see what I'm doing here when I'm strafing, but I'm keeping the crosshair on the target. And so it's fairly easy. But if I do, I'll wait for the target to come up again. If I do a 360, it throws off my aim, right? So I gotta recover and aim again. Just like that. And jumping and leaning is muscle memory. You shouldn't have to look at the buttons. Same with leaning, same with crouching. No matter what it is, it's all muscle memory. You shouldn't have to look at those buttons when you hit them. So that's why once in a while I might miss the button because I'm not actually looking at it when I hit it. So you practice that. Just practice. I like to be try to make myself disoriented and have to find the target again really quickly. That's when I try to practice. All the time I'm strafing. So yeah, that's basically the idea. That's a typical training session, and hope you guys got something from that. And next time you go in the range, you can practice that stuff. Hope you guys liked it. I will make another video on this. So I think there's a few more details I could get into. If anybody's interested in that, let me know. I'll make another video on this. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more. Thanks a lot.